Good day, Dr. Naram and Dr. Clint. My name is Elizabeth Govender. I am 25 and I am from Johannesburg, South Africa. I've been following the both of you for some time now, and I am a huge fan of the both of you. I've been watching you on YouTube and on TEDx, and I was extremely excited when I saw that you had posted out a competition. I am passionate about healing, passionate about moving from artificial to natural medicines. I'm passionate about helping people, and I do truly believe that that is my calling in life, and that I would never be fully fulfilled and happy until I am doing that. So this is just a step in that direction, another step in that direction. During my video, I've put together some footage, both from different sources as well as footage that I've taken myself of the neighborhood that I live in. I live in the heart of the city of Johannesburg, also called the City of Gold, where millions and thousands of people come every day to seek a better future from all over Africa, all over the country of South Africa. So I'd like to expose you to the environment and what is happening right now, the different things that are happening with regards to recycling, as well as the negative effects of the things and the processes that are happening within the city. South Africa is an amazing country with beautiful and kind people, and I hope that through my video you will notice some of that. But there is also a deep root suffering here that is felt within our nation, and that is felt with people who expose themselves to it in a way. A large part of our country, because of the high crime rate here, keep themselves closed off and bubbled in their own environments and never really notice the people who are suffering so much within our country. So another goal of this is to maybe expose people to that without giving off the effect that they can't do anything or that it's too unsafe, because that is a very large fear within South Africa. People are afraid of helping those in need because of the crime here. So I'd like to expose everyone, as well as yourselves, to how South Africa is, as well as the suffering that our people are experiencing. Personally, I do believe that everything is connected. I believe that the energy that flows in our environment flows in us, and I believe that the energy that flows in us flows into our environment. So the state of the city at the moment, the state of our streets, the high level of pollution and litter is no shock to one observing it when you see the state of our people and the deep suffering that our people are experiencing. We have one of the highest rates, if not the highest rates, of inequality in the world. We also have one of the highest rates of HIV and AIDS in the world, as well as the highest crime rates in the world. So there are a lot of things going against us, but our country is beautiful, our people are beautiful, our cultures are beautiful, and it is so worth saving. I'd like to also mention that the apartheid has caused a lot of wounds within our people, within our mindsets as individuals, wounds that we're still licking up until today. As I was saying, we have a lot of wounds here and a lot of suffering, and from a lot of the people that I've spoken to, especially the poor, it's very difficult to look outside of oneself when someone is struggling every day and hustling to put food on the table for their families. It's very difficult for one to look outside and notice that the environment needs saving, that one needs to recycle, that you need to be more clean in what you produce and what you use. And that's a struggle that remains in South Africa. Being environmentally conscious is seen as a privilege of the privileged. So yeah, that's definitely a big challenge that we face. But I definitely believe that to solve the issues that we have within our country and in our world, within our environment as a whole, something needs to be done to the individual. where we need to move from a state of unconsciousness to a state of consciousness, where we need more self-love so that we can reflect that love outwards onto our environment. I hope that you enjoyed my video. I hope that it is informative and that it is inspiring. And I look forward to hearing more from you. Thank you.